It is a story about an extraordinary team's success, and it's a story about an extraordinary individual's success. There really wasn't anything special about us, about any one individual, but what was extraordinary was the potential that was within us. We go out of our way to make it more difficult for ourselves. I know that sounds a bit odd, but and it's all about style. And the idea is that when a climb or a mountain involves a higher degree or level of commitment, it also inspires a higher level of performance. And that's what we're after. At least that's what some of us are after. And each time I went out to do a new climb, to take on a new challenge, I discovered new strengths. We are more than we know. And once we realize this, may we never settle for less. To climb Mount Everest by a route that had never been climbed before in its entirety, a difficult route, and to do it in what we called, what we considered as mountaineers, as climbers, in good style. What does that mean? It means to climb the mountain with the minimum amount of resources and the maximum amount of efficiency. Now, their odds of success are not so good, but if they do succeed, they make history. And they changed the game. What you figure out pretty quick in this place is that the only constants are change and adversity. You never know what to expect from day to day, other than it's going to be hard. We've got very little time to do a whole bunch of work. Small problems or small challenges become big problems in a very short time. You have a very limited amount of energy, and you can't afford to squander it on just surviving. If you're just surviving, failure isn't far behind. If you can't get up and shoulder a load day after day, you're marked as an inconsistent performer, and you don't get a chance to go on that final summit bid team because people aren't going to want to place their bets on you. We've been working for 4 years. Who's it going to be in the end, the most consistent performer? It never feels like you got enough strength. It never feels like you've got enough resources, that you rested well enough, that you've got the conditions you need, that you want to do what may well be the most difficult thing you've ever done in your life. And what's your choice? You go home or you stay the course. Thriving is not about working harder. It's not about carrying a heavier pack or working a longer day. It's about using what little you do have really well. When things get really difficult, I got this little mantra that goes like this: better is possible. And for me, that triggers optimism. I